Ernest Everett Jess, born August 14, 1883, died October 27, 1941. Born in Charleston, South Carolina, during this time, 40% of all U.S. slaves entered the country. His father and grandfather were dock builders. When he was 4 years old, his dad passed away from alcoholism. After that, Mary Matthews Jess, his mother, was the sole supporter for him, his younger brother, and his younger sister. When Jess was young, he was sick with typhoid fever for 6 weeks. The fever affected his memory, and he had to relearn how to read and write.
At 13, his mother sent him to the Colored Normal Industrial, Agricultural, and Mechanical College of South Carolina, later known as South Carolina State. Because his mother believed that schools in the South were inferior, he then transferred to Kimball Union Academy at only age 16. During his second year at Kimball Union Academy, he went home to discover that his mother had been buried an hour before he arrived. Despite these obstacles, he continued his education. He graduated his third year and had the highest grades in all his classes. After receiving his bachelor's degree, he later went on to graduate school at Dartmouth College and was also at the top of the class there as well. During the early 1900s, blacks couldn't teach at a PWI, so Jess took the best option he thought was for him, teaching at Howard University. Jess was known for his work in marine biology, cytology, and parthenogenesis. At Howard University, Jess and three others came together to establish the first ever Omega Psi Phi fraternity group. Jess also had many other great achievements in life. In 1939, Jess released his first book called The Biology of the Cell Surface. In 1940, shortly after releasing his book, Jess was in Germany doing research on cells. During this time, it was at the peak of World War II. All German soldiers told foreigners to flee the country. Instead of leaving, he stayed to continue his research and was held captive at a prisoner of war camp. But while he was in prison, he became very ill. Later in 1940, he was released and later died from pancreatic cancer in 1941.